Hoo-wee.
I was almost gonna listen to the whole song. I'm in that kind of mood.
Were you?
Yeah, I was.
I saw your thumb basing on your thigh.
Yeah. Do a little swim. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J Oakerson.
Hey, 844-COMEDY-9's the number, the Bonfire at Sirius XM for all of your dick and badge picks.
844-266-3399 if you're dumb like me and can't put numbers into letters.
But the email's always the same in any language, the Bonfire at Sirius XM.
It's a superior mode of communication.
For all of your, you ready? Holiday, cute pet.
Thank you.
Dick and Vatch Piff.
Finally, you listen to me.
I did a little both.
We spent some time together this weekend.
We spent a lot of time together.
Opening up for the Impractical Jokers in old Camden, New Jersey. Old Big J's stomping ground.
That was not my stomping ground.
No, but you know what? I'm going to tell people it was. Old Camden, New Jersey.
I remember taking long walks down Broadway, getting mugged and fucked for money.
The wrong side of the street, Oakerson.
Picking up a little smack from my friends.
I'll tell you this, man. I know we don't verbally jerk each other off a lot. Very impressive to watch you murder in front of 7,000 people.
You murdered too, buddy.
I did all right. Let's be honest. It was great watching. I had such a good time. And I say this to people a lot. Best part about doing this radio show is you're a guy I still watch in the city. Like, I still like watching. Because, you know, you get...
I watch you too, buddy.
You watch stand-up enough, though, and you get like...
Sure.
You just get like, oh, God, I got it. Or you're just not really in the mood for it.
Absolutely. Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
But, man, watching you, and I told you this the night of the show, it's from, like, those going on tour with Korn and doing Oddball, but holy shit, I had fun watching you do comedy on Saturday.
Oh, thank you.
To the point where I was driving home, and I was like, yeah, I got it right.
It was cool. High School Crush came.
Yes! I didn't get to meet her, because backstage, it was like they were the fucking Beatles.
Yeah.
And Practical Jokers, man, they got some serious fans.
No shit, but High School Crush, it was great.
Yeah, that was probably awesome.
A little heavy set, wearing an air cast.
Ooh, what happened to her?
I won.
So she had to literally had to hobble up, like limp up to you.
Yeah.
And then you were like, beg for my attention.
Yeah. Maybe I'll come say hello.
Did you give her the fancy king hand?
No, I was super sweet.
Yeah.
You know what was annoying?
What?
It did annoy the shit out of me. So I was feeling good. Show was good.
It's great.
Had a good time. Got to hang out with the Jokers. Got to meet them all officially. You know, we're good friends with Sal.
We know Sal well. But
Sal's become one of my really good buddies. Did not know Merck, Hugh, or Joe Gatto very well at all. But got to meet them, which was really, really neat. They seemed to enjoy the show. But going out there... Yeah, it was neat. It was like a cool experience, but I've already told her that I'm going to do a benefit. She wants me to help her do a benefit.
Yeah.
And I said yes to it already, but what annoyed me was I gave her the kudos that... Here's the thing. Did you have a long-term crush?
Yeah, I had multiple long-term crushes.
And you didn't close?
None of them.
Okay. That's this.
I got a bunch of cold cases. Floating around.
Still open.
I got, a bunch of...
Hey, this reminds me of ninth grade, cold case. I'm going to open it up.
Jeannie Adams, sophomore year.
Hey, evidence, can I just get one more look at those files, please?
Hey, do you have that receipt from dinner of homecoming my senior year with a girl didn't fuck me? I want to look over something.
I'm going to listen to the tapes again. There's got to be something in there.
She did have a glass of red wine. I knew it.
There was something in there.
I dropped her off, and then she was gone. She had to have fucked someone. Who did she fuck on homecoming?
But how lame was this? Worst kept secret in high school.
Yeah.
How into this chick I was. She knew. I laid it out there pretty good several times.
Dude.
What?
I think I know where this is going, but keep going.
She did this. I was like, and her husband was with her.
Yeah.
Very nice guy. Her friends were really cool. She was great. It was great to see her. But I did the old, I said, you know, I was telling my girlfriend the other day, I go, yeah, I was like, how fun it was. Like, you know, those days where you'd wear my starter jacket.
Yeah, that's a huge early 90s. That's pretty
I'd go, oh, man, Janessa's wearing my fucking... She's wearing my starter jacket.
Nothing makes a teenage boy's heart sing like the girl they're in love with wearing their clothing.
And she did this move. She goes, what? No way. You know, it's like, Shut the fuck up.
Wait, she said that she didn't wear it?
No. She was doing more of the, like, you, really? Like, that maybe it was a big deal to you that I wore your star, like, you were into me like that? It's like, shut the fuck up, Janessa.
Yeah, you know what that is, though? That's like...
It made me feel... Here's the thing. It made me feel weirdly small all over again.
Yeah, because that's what they do, Jay. That's why they're there. No, you thought she was going to make you feel good?
I didn't think she... I didn't.
Why are you a comedian?
I have nothing about wanting her to say... No, she always... I'm not looking for any of that, because I hate all that shit, too. It's like, oh, I always had a thing for you. She didn't do that, but I'm saying I'm not looking for that either. But just to almost acknowledge, you know, like, laugh that off. I had a girl one time named Melissa.
Or be like, you're sweet. You want at least acknowledgement.
Just don't make it seem like you had no fucking clue.
Or... Well, see, here's the whole thing about that, is that's exactly why... That's who they are in their life, where they're like, they just have that power over you. I guarantee all the girls I had crushes on, they could have, the seams could have completely bursted on all of them. They could just be gelatic messes, just like big, just like, ah, but they would still have that mental thing.
We're all pushing 40. You know, yeah. I'm my group.
I'm pushing mid-30s,
mm-hmm.
And it's still, no matter how confident I am, no matter how many beautiful women I've dated, been in love with, any of that, the ones that will always take me back to Aurora Dan are those girls, and all they have to do is simply not acknowledge me. And it will, and that's what happened.
She acknowledged, and then even posted that thing on Facebook, Soder. That's what she posted on Facebook.
No, but I'm saying...
She posted the pictures that we took together.
Yes, but you're not. I'm saying that she didn't acknowledge your crush in the way you wanted. Because when you want that kind of situation, you want her being like, I can't believe I never dated you. You want that...
I don't know. I don't want a bullshit.
That's what I'm saying, though. You want it honestly.
I don't want to. No, it's just like, it's like. Oh yeah, like you. I would. I swear to you, I'm okay with.
You loved me, and I didn't love you.
The honesty of some version that. Of like, it's like I know.
Okay.
Right. Even if you want to do like the old arbitrary, like I know I was so like you know I was just so into dating these kind of guys. And
yes.
Blah, blah, blah.
Okay, I got it.
You know,
yes.
I don't even. I swear to you. I don't even need, because it sounds like I'm asking for the, but look at you now, and the blah, yes. blah, blah, and showbiz. And
which
and
is I, really what we all want.
That I would take that.
Yeah.
Not what I'm looking. I was looking for a simple, like, let's laugh together.
About
the fact how lame that was. Don't play like you didn't fucking know it was a thing happening.
Yeah.
That I'd come in on fucking snowy days and immediately offer you my coat in our ghetto-ass, heatless fucking school.
Man.
What? And you come and you came in a jacket.
Can I ask you what team?
LA Kings.
Oh, that's starter jacket wise.
Yeah.
You are looking at the Audi.
Yeah.
That is the Lexus of starter jacket. I had an Anaheim Ducks.
Don't know a goddamn thing about hockey.
Wayne Gretzky, they were good on NHL 93 Sega Genesis. That's what I know about the LA Kings.
Didn't even matter to me. It's black and silver.
That's badass. I had my dad, old Gary. Threw back a couple too many rum and cokes, went and got me an Anaheim Mighty Ducks, purple and green.
That is not a dad who loves you.
But I'll tell you this, if I was black, that would have been the coolest. But I was white, so it was the worst.
But it was, I felt rejected all over again, simply in her being like, what? Mm-hmm. You're crazy.
Yeah.
And then writes on Facebook, like, had a really great time.
Seeing my old pal.
Seeing my favorite high school bud.
Oh, fuck off, lady.
Jay Oakerson. And you're like, we weren't fucking best high school bud, but I did so much dumb shit for that girl.
Yeah, because you were in love with her.
So, that's what I'm saying. Like, you don't know? You're like, I fucking sent you flowers arbitrarily one time with my grandmother's credit card.
Oh.
Had to make.
Come on, Jay. Did you?
Yeah, Lou.
Do you have a riding lawnmower and make a proposition to her?
Fuck this telescope. I want to bone you for two nights.
Yeah, Jay.
And totally had that voice too. Still
yeah,
has
Jay.
Right. But see, it was just like.
But I understand what you're doing, because there's the lack of acknowledgement of it being a real situation, skirting the past or skirting the topic, and not being like. You were in love with me, and I didn't do shit about it, and now I'm seeing you perform in front of 7,000 people and do amazing. Yes, I understand.
Stole
exactly.
The show, someone say.
You did. Stop. You absolutely did. Dude, you're set. And I was telling Christine, too. I was telling him when you were getting waters.
I don't believe anything she said.
I was having a blast watching him. I was cackling like an asshole. And she was, I like that Christine just goes, yes, yes, you were.
So, yeah, she did that, but it was fine. If I can go back through time,
yeah.
Flowers. No one sends flowers to somebody else in fucking high school.
High school, that is the equivalent of buying a woman a car now.
You might as well.
If you bought a bitch a car now, flowers are that's the same as...
Because flowers are $50 for a shit arrangement.
And you don't even know. This is pre-internet. You had to call a place.
I called a local florist.
Jesus. Not only do you reinvest in the community.
Yeah. This girl didn't give a shit about me. Yeah. And I was fueling the local economy.
You were spurning it. Your love was fueling the local South Jersey economy.
You twat.
Oh, man.
I
And what is
this one?
I'm just, mm-hmm. That makes me so happy in hindsight, because what a set, like, for her to watch, and then I just know the crushing disappointment of her not acknowledging the situation.
Nothing I wanted. Brought them all back. Brought her and her friends back. They wanted to meet, Sal.
I saw that, by the way, which looked cool.
Walked them all back, and they all got their pictures.
Oh, did it.
And by the way, she's married, and the guy seems like a good dude. I'm sure she's happy as kid. I'm not trying to fuck her.
I know, but that's where I jump in my mind, is you sadly listening to this out the window of your awesome hotel room they got us, and Christine being like, hey, can we fuck?
No.
She didn't acknowledge that she didn't like me.
I don't like you now.
Now no one could fuck me. She's locked up my dick box.
Dude, I pulled back on my second. I was like the starter jacket thing, and I was like, oh, and I remember the funny thing was, you know, your thing was like you were a dancer. She like danced, you know, mm-hmm. dance classes. She was all into that kind of. I think that's what she does now. She teaches that.
Oh, God damn.
I talk about the ninth grade dance.
Yeah.
I go, and I got that one dance where I was like, oh, I'm dancing with Janessa. And I go, and I remember it was so funny because, like, I was just massacring the rhythm. You were doing some weird, you weren't just doing a side to side as we were all prepared for in ninth grade. She was throwing a 1-2-1-1. Now, I'm okay with that.
Okay.
I could do that now. Now I could do that, no problem. Maybe even that time I could have done it, but I was so, like, holy shit.
Dude, touching the girl you like in ninth grade, with Stephanie Holmes, when I got to the point where I could say hi to her in the hallway, I've smoked cocaine in my life, and that's about as high as I got.
Well,
that's
news to me.
She was a sophomore. It happened once. It was in Clifton, New Jersey. It was a dark.
Bonfire breaking news. Is Dan Soder high on freebase? Will he go the route of his hero, Richard Pryor?
He's burned myself. But
burn victim.
He's like, he wasn't a tenth of the
help
crowd.
Me. You start pouring Jack Daniels on yourself.
But I just run down the street in Astoria, and they're like, let him die. When Stephanie Holmes, she was a sophomore, I was a freshman. When she said hi to me in the hallway, mm-hmm. That was like, I could have jumped through the roof. So I know exactly.
Big deal, dude.
It's huge deal.
Let me tell you
were dancing with her?
Let me tell you something. Samantha Montavani came back to school in ninth grade.
Great name, too.
Samantha Montavani showed back up.
Say that three times fast.
Samantha Montavani, Samantha Montavani, Samantha Montavani.
All right, you got it.
She was a sweatpants sweatshirt kid.
Yeah. Coming back with a body on
Went away for a year. Maybe went to the Catholic school for a year or two.
She just trained like Rocky and Rocky IV.
Dude, she came back like she should be doing fucking hot licks in the cup in front of a Ferrari.
She should be on Lowrider magazine, just
dude,
ducked down.
She was just tits out. She went to total top ponytail, sticky, hairsprayed hair.
That's like that's the helmet for BJ.
Crazy makeup. I mean, she was so hot.
BJ war paint.
Still, Janessa's the girl.
Still, in your heart of hearts, the dancer, the lovely girl that wore your big LA Kings jacket.
So thank God the other night. Thank God the other night.
By the way, ripping it. Just ripping it.
I'm talking about when I'm talking to her afterwards.
Yeah.
And I'm telling her the stories. And I'm dancing with you. And you're doing this crazy thing. And I was so locked in and focused. And I go, and I'm laughing. You couldn't have been less interested.
Yeah.
You were just looking over your shoulder, and I'm laughing. This is a million years ago. For the life of me, I swear to you, I don't hold grudges.
This is legitimately during the first Clinton administration?
I chalk this up to being fucking 15 innocence.
Yes.
Because it all is.
The sweetest of loves.
In my world of 15-year-olds, and I mean this.
Wait, you were 15 in ninth grade? Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
In my world of this, 14, 15,
yeah.
In my world of these things, innocence was a big, and again, that might be time changes and stuff. Like, I know 15 now, it's like cocksuck parties at fucking Frankie's house or whatever.
Well, they're all Snapchatting each other's buttholes to each other.
Yeah, no shit, but this was not, this was still an innocent time. I had no other, I didn't even have intention past taking her to a movie.
This is...
maybe kissing.
15, the heaviest I got into was some dry humping.
Sure.
A good old
but
Gene.
I was fat kid, was not going to get there.
Gene on Gene?
Wasn't going to go there. So
feel that pelvic bone.
I'm happy for everything. I stopped telling her the story after the not paying attention to me saying, like, she's looking at other ways while we're dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was going to follow up with, like, the. And again, I'm just talking about it as humor, but I'm like, she's reacting in a way that I'm like, oh, I'm just going to stop. I was going to be like, oh, isn't it still funny that I always have that song on my iPod? Not in a crazy, like, this was our song. Yeah. Because it's funny. It's a really funny song. You have Mint Condition, Pretty Brown Eyes.
Oh. Please, please have it.
The video is on YouTube.
Go,
don't worry.
Go get it, Lou Dog. Go get it, Lou Dog.
Yeah, we're going to have to bring it up on YouTube. It is, dude, this, when you hear the song, you're going to fucking, this is a great one to slow dance to. By the way, she was doing the right rhythm on this one.
Oh. I don't even know where to go, though. And I'm 32. Oh, now I got it.
Well, now come over here to me.
All right.
Bring your mic.
Yeah. All right.
Here's what she was doing.
All right. I'm going to go side to side. You do what she was doing.
You got to go up, though. You're the
okay.
girl.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're expecting this.
Christine, you want a video of this?
We're expecting this, right?
Yeah. I mean, this is straight ninth grade dance.
Here's what I'm getting.
Yeah.
Here's what I'm getting. It's from her. Oh, so yeah, now you got to be me.
Okay.
That's what you expect. Here's what I'm getting. Put your hands on my hips. I'm getting this. She's going, she's like,
oh, no. Oh, no. I don't know where to go on this.
Two, one.
Oh, this bitch threw curveballs.
Two curveballs.
Oh,
what video? I stopped telling her.
Yeah.
Because she's not getting it. Now, in defense, it's a funny
on.
Thing.
Just let me.
Well, yeah, no, let that song roll.
Lou,
let,
kick it up a little just for a second. Waiting to be
on leave. Oh,
this is open shirt, baggy pants music. This is open shirt, no undershirt.
Oh, and I have patches on my thighs
yes.
that are cow skin.
Ooh. There it is.
Lord. Yeah.
Oh, this is like, they all look like they're cast members on A Different World.
Oh, hell yeah. A lot of pastels and shit. The most non-threatening era of black people.
Pretty brown eyes.
Ooh.
You want the kicker?
Yeah.
She had brown eyes.
Oh.
So.
I just want to come back with a beat hit.
Ooh.
And try yourself back on.
Ooh.
You guys want to take a bet right now?
I usually come before the second verse is
I
over.
Got a dollar says there's a talk breakdown. Merc face.
I agree. Gotta be a talk down.
What about
I'll go no talk down.
No talk down. Hugo.
Talk down.
No talk down.
Oh shit, the room is
Lou. Good.
No bullshit rap. Nope.
No talk down though. That's all.
No, I say no talk down, no you talk. Say no talk. So you throw a dollar in?
Sure.
Me and we'll all split the winnings. Hugo, you say no, you say talk down.
Oh,
oh shit. No, you say no talk.
I'm going definite talk down.
Okay.
Like a boat in the back of the head picking up money off the ground. I just start bleeding over my eye. Wait
dollars
for it.
Are in.
Quit breaking my heart.
And you don't know if there's a talk.
I have no idea.
Can I add one if there is one? I have the voice for
oh,
it.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, jeez.
Breaking my heart.
I'm trying to go side to side, but you keep changing it up. Doing it. One and two. Oh, why are you confusing me so much, Janice? Wait, not her name's not Janice. What was it? What's her name?
Janessa.
Oh, Janessa. Janice is Lewis, our friend's sister.
No, that's Janice. This is Janessa.
Yeah, Janessa. I've been waiting since seventh grade to talk to you. Now it's ninth grade. I got some chest hairs, a couple pubes over my dick, and all I want to do is dance side to side with you, girl. But you do all this crazy motion. Why you gotta mess a brother up? My stepdad's picking me up at 9:30.
1211. That's for fools and suckers.
That adds up to making no sense.
Oh, oh shit. That's a talk up. That's a talk up.
That's a talk down. Talk up, talk down. No need, suckers, because Murkface Andy and Dan Soder just made something out. I forget my name.
But, that's a talk up. That's fair.
I give it.
Yeah.
If you get that, you get that bass guy in there to go, girl, don't even matter.
You know what I just did today? I woke up and I found a dry piece of poop in my butt hairs. Ooh. I picked it out in the shower and it hurt like hell. Hurt like a sumbitch. You was still asleep. And I said something and it scurried you away. Dried poop is our glue.
But I have always...
So real quick before this.
Sure.
You dancing with her in ninth grade. We had this...
huge moment.
In Denver, there was this place called Hollywood Legends. And on Sundays, they would do teenager night, where if you had a school ID that said you were a sophomore...
Circus Town. That was ours.
Yeah. So every city has this. Where
yeah, like, but ours was at one of those places, like, it was also the animatronic, like, you know,
what?
Country Bears gang type thing there.
So,
it was like a Chuck E. Cheese, but they would do a teen dance night where they would do, like, music and a DJ, but, like, behind all that was still, like, you know, the fucking... A fucking, like, you know,
yeah,
a
jug
leopard,
bear?
A leopard playing a fucking washboard.
Yeah, coyote on a stand-up bass.
Yeah.
Bolt, bolt, bolt. Don't forget, but kids.
But it's like the basin with
it's teenage night, so don't forget to finger fuck your favorite lady.
Don't double bag it. That doesn't work.
You don't want to be a teen mom like our slide guitar player. Yeah.
Shelly the squirrel.
Yeah, I was drunk and I said he could come.
But there was ours.
I thought I was too young to get pregnant. I put a soda bottle in me and it didn't work.
Oh, well, Shelly learned her lesson that day. Now meet her son playing the upside down paint cans.
So there was a dance club in Denver called Hollywood Legends, but the thing was, it was a real club every other night. But on Sundays, they did teen night, and if you had your school ID, you could get in. But oddly enough, there'd be like 18 and 19-year-olds. It was like 16 and 19, 16
all right,
to 20.
All right.
Straight up. And there was just like, dude, one of my buddies hooked up with this girl that they just called Jiggles, because she was like, she would do like...
She had the fat tits.
Fat tits, fat ass, yeah. But she would do like the dances. But the girl, Stephanie Holmes, that I was in love with, would go there and wear like... almost like sport bra looking thing, like little halter top things.
And baggy jeans.
Oh yeah, get the Aaliyah treatment.
The fly girl
loved it.
Good look.
Here's me.
You throwing some overall straps over
my
that
body?
I'll be honest with you, I'm just gonna jerk off in front of her.
You should just
it's
do
a public
it.
Crime.
So I, you know, I was all gussied up in my old sweetest old Navy that just opened. So I got a bunch of great gear, bunch of khakis. We go. One night I see her dancing.
You tucking a button down, buttoned all the way up, but no tie?
I did, no, untucked, baggy khakis.
I have to picture you dressed more like Color Me Bad, but
I wish. No, I didn't have that kind of confidence. Untucked, body, you know, I was tall and skinny, so I tried to make my body look as big as possible.
You use the same theory you would use to scare a bear away?
Yeah.
Get big. Get big.
Stephanie, this is Dan. Just walking up to, got my hands up. Like
it's me, Dan. I'd like to go to a dance with you.
I would like to maybe hang out with you. Will you be my girlfriend? So she's dancing. Dude, I remember it was Aaliyah's song, Are You That Somebody? Yeah. Are you that so? Yeah. Baby girl. Better known. And dude, I got so nervous. Yes, that's it. I got so nervous. We're in a dance club. It's a straight up fucking dance club.
Dance club.
I asked her to dance.
Dance.
Like I was. It was the 50s.
50s. Yeah.
Scared sophomore boy.
Shirt is untucked.
Old Navy. But I walked up to
metal
her.
Metal on
like,
my belt buckle. And metal on the part that goes.
And she's
two.
Like grabbing the pole, like really dancing. And I go behind her and go, can I dance with you? Like a fucking asshole. She was like, it was one of those things where she was like,
Dude, just start humping my ass, bro.
Exactly.
I was like, what's your problem?
Yeah.
Didn't get that. Never had that feeling.
Well, I'll tell you this. Can I tell you this?
Mm-hmm.
Was so on cloud nine for even getting to hump her ass this song through my pants that literally I could have ran home. I could have ran back to Aurora. I was that jacked up.
But I'll always give credit to Melissa Patrizio.
Great names. Gotta keep the names going. Real crush names, real crush stories. No bullshit.
Melissa Patrizio was the hot blonde in school.
Okay. Also, I like that all your names
all
are
all the
like,
girls in our school, by the way, really weirdly into dance.
And also all named after pasta dishes. Like Laura Gabarino, she's a Laura Cannoli sauce. Laura Baked Ziti.
Her name was Beth Pastina.
She went, oh, you didn't hang out with Gina Fajul? Why the fuck?
Her name's Mary Pasta Fajuts.
Oh, hey, you guys, I'm going to go over to Jenny Penny Alavanti's house.
Her name's Marie Calamai. Rigaud.
Oh, Rigaud. Someone's real quick. You are, yeah.
Yeah, but let me just finish the thing with Melissa Patrizio. Crush. You know what? Not even a major crush. Mm-hmm. Just hot chick. In fact, thought it was just completely out of my realm of giving it a shot.
Yeah.
Halloween party.
Okay.
Heather Cabler's Halloween party.
Dude, great Halloween parties. Heather Cabler's? Was her dad out of town again?
No. Both parents.
Her stepmom, Jane.
Heather Cabler throws down Halloween party. I go.
What were you dressed as?
Here's what I was dressed as. Full karate gi.
Yes.
Spiky bracelet.
You were a double dragon.
A fat guy in a karate gi and a spiky bracelet.
Oh, God. Jay, you got to rope it into something.
A fat kid with a tail wearing a karate gi.
How old are you?
This may have been like pretty. This is probably 12, 13.
Did you have the tail?
Oh, yeah, the tail's popping. Tail may have been dyed blonde, may have been in a braid, may have used my braces, rubber band to tie it off.
Excuse me?
You heard what I said. You heard everything I said.
You had apocalyptic gang leader hair? Like stuff that you put in your hair from a...
Hey, fairies. Yeah. Looks like you guys trying to make your way past Coney Island if you want to get past it.
Hey, boppers. We got a news story. There's a certain... Chubby's freshman that's at a house party in a karate gi and a spiky bracelet. He's ready to bop.
Don't remember how, but me and Melissa Patrizio hitting it off.
It's going nuts. This is the blonde?
The blonde.
Okay.
We're hitting it off. This is before Janessa.
Okay.
But I'm just saying, like, here, I'm bringing this down. This comes back to what I appreciated about Melissa Patrizio. She, so we hit it off that night. She takes my bracelet. Which is a sign. Oh, I'm sorry. Not only was I wearing a spiky bracelet, karate gi.
Yeah.
Karate gi, spiky bracelet. For some reason, some pretty slick shades. Plastic, black and clear striped.
Perfect.
You know, the ones that would give you that good fucking jerk off volleyball teacher tan.
Yeah, the old highway patrolman.
Yes.
AKA the Randy Johnson.
We're not talking about more Dog the Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, I think we're along the same. No, okay, I know yours. There's a slight difference between the Randy Johnsons and the Dog the Bounty Hunters.
Right. So, she, at the end of the night, when we're hitting it off, I'm pretty sure we didn't even kiss, peck. Maybe we peck kissed.
All right.
Don't remember.
Which is a big deal.
Huge deal. But this is a different time.
Yeah, Carly Hendricks.
13 now, they are sucking each other's dick. It's upsetting, but it's true.
13 years old, Carly Hendricks.
They're not sucking each other's dicks. That makes it sound gay.
Yeah.
They're sucking dicks now at 13.
At 13 years old.
I mean, not my 13-year-old daughter, because she's an angel who would never do that, and I just turned a blind eye.
Yeah, of course.
So,
Carly Hendricks, 13 years old, held my hand. I had a boner so hard, I think I could rip through denim.
Sam, we have... We're neck and neck here, dude. Kim Kropinski held my hands.
Nice.
Huge thing.
Old Kropinski.
And even did this. My house party.
Yeah.
Sixth grade.
Oh, boy.
We all got to run. We are out back at the park. We all got to run back to the house. She gets up off the steps, charges up a few steps, reaches the hand back for me.
Oh.
Come on. And just like, we might as well, when she grabbed my hand and I grabbed it, we might as well, it's like the whole world just disappeared and we were just like floating. We were like like snowboarding down rainbows together.
You took a ride on the majestic back of a love beast.
Sunshine.
Ah!
Whoa.
Man, it feels good.
It's time to feel good.
Hey.
So, that was the weekend. Monday, I go to school expecting this is going to be like, all right, lunchtime comes.
Yeah.
Let me go sit my new baby girl.
Yeah.
We're a thing now. We're a thing. I believe we left that night sort of acknowledging we're dating.
Okay.
And I will say, for how bad this goes.
Yes.
That was two huge days for me.
That Sunday.
This isn't like cell phone every time you get contact anyway.
Oh, that was phone calls. That was your mom going, there's an Amanda on the phone.
Yes.
And you're like.
But I wasn't even...
What the fuck did you just say to me, Trish?
It was all so new to me.
I take the phone like a young businessman.
Tokyo.
Yeah. Soder speaking.
Yeah.
It was all so new to me.
Yeah.
This thing that was happening that I didn't even have a concern. I assume the next time I talk to her is going to be in school.
Yeah, and this is, you're so young in life that you don't ever see the other shoe dropping.
Not even sort of.
So you're like, we're in love.
We're a thing now.
Yeah.
Look, you know, I'm not as bad
as
I thought.
A tale as old as time.
I'm not.
Romeo and Juliet.
I can't believe it. Melissa Patrizio is into me. This is big.
Melissa Patrizio.
Melissa Patrizio we're talking
Melissa
about here.
Melissa baked noodles with tomato sauce on top and a little bit of fresh Parmesan.
Yeah. You know, Melissa Patrizio with a fresh up app.
Melissa Patrizio, a nice side of garlic bread. Don't forget to try the snails.
Oh, I give you a Chardonnay.
I got a Malone. I got a Malone.
You treat me like a pack of gooch.
I'm going to get you some layered cookies later.
I'm feeling good. Yeah. So I will always give her.
Monday morning.
I always give Melissa Patrizio that I had a Saturday, Sunday.
And a Monday
floating
morning.
On, and Monday morning floating on. In fact,
Might as well have been getting ready for your wedding.
Couldn't wait to get to school on Monday.
Ah, where is this bus? It's got to take me to my love.
I was a walker.
Okay.
What time is fucking lunch so I can go hang out with my baby girl?
It's always obscenely early, like 10:45 lunch.
I feel guilt. I'm starting to feel guilt because she's probably missing me somewhere in this building.
She's pinging around like a lost dog. She's barking at every shut door.
Where has anyone seen Jay?
I need Jay Oakerson. He's wearing a karate gi. He's got a spiked bracelet on and cool shades.
I wore the same thing so she would know it was me.
Yeah. Remember, this is your scent is on me. Look, it's your scent.
He goes, did you wear your karate gi again? He goes, never took it off. A karate man stays prepared.
I rolled around in it for 48 hours, hoping to catch some more whiffs of you.
Well, I should have watched it. How many times I beat dick in this thing?
Oh, I just dry humped and let it go wherever it may go.
Why is the karate gi white? You know.
From a wedding day.
Batch one.
Wink.
So... I find her.
Yeah.
At lunch.
At lunch. She had a table with her friends.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a tough approach. This is a real tough approach. Did you breach? Did you fucking flank them?
I've had 2 days of walking around so tall.
Yeah. I probably wondering.
I've lost 60 pounds.
Did you? Yeah. And you got jacked and you started growing a beard.
I must have weird mirrors because Melissa Patrizio's fucking digging the kid.
And. You probably told your mom about her positive personality traits for those 2 days. Did you like tell her?
Probably giving my mom's from her, my grandmother. I love my grandmother.
Because my mom
probably let her know that, you know, it's like, you know, mom, some things are going to change around here now. I'm kind of seeing somebody. She's not moving in, but, you know, I wanted to have an open invite.
I
want you to like her. But I'm not leaving her if you don't.
Yeah. And listen, I just want to tell you, sparks flew. There's gas on the fire. It's been 2 days.
There's a real thing. You know, Mom, sit down. I'm going to teach you a thing right now about, it's chemistry. You can't fight this.
Mom, what was it like when you first saw Grandpa? When you saw Pop-Pop?
It was nothing like that, right? It's probably you guys just were arranged. It was like, you know, it's a thing.
Were you guys in a breadline?
War was over. You guys were trying to link it up for pure, you know, it's situationally, it made sense.
Mom, do you remember the first time you watched color TV? That's what it felt like when Lauren Patrizio touched
Melissa, me. Melissa Patrizio.
Damn it, I'm sorry. All these fucking white girl names with difficult Italian last names.
I approach confident, holding my tray, school lunch in it.
What do you remember the lunch? A lot of times traumatic events, senses, smells, and
relate
tastes.
To your food.
Yeah.
It's probably, I mean, if I'm guessing this school, it was junk. It was still the era of like they didn't give two shits.
Yeah.
It wasn't even somebody making a bunch of shitty hamburgers.
Mm.
It was like a pre-packaged tin. They heat all the tins at
Army
once.
Army meal.
Yes. Yeah. You open up, there was like succotash, Salisbury steak, and maybe like, you know, mashed potatoes or something.
Yeah, eating like an old widower.
Oh, we lost our girl callers. I wasn't like, if you're listening. We had Beth and Brandy. Beth and Brandy, call back. I like our girl callers. We get so few. Plus, they were good things they want to talk about, so please call back with those. So Melissa Patrizio, I walk over, I approach school lunch.
Which, by the way, The cafeteria lunch at this age might as well be Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all in one room with everyone watching you type your post as you typed it.
Yeah. I think I even went 2% milk instead of a chocolate milk to let her know that I'm trying to make changes for her.
Yeah, you're
gonna, I want to live. I have a reason to live now.
Well, you want her to just to be filled with pure sexual excitement when you rip off your shirt, which will be 2 to 3 days from now when you guys are making love.
2 to 3 days, we're probably going to get into it. We're going to we're going to talk.
It's going to move hot and heavy.
My whole thing was I was going to sit down and start talking family.
Yeah. Asking her, what's your ideal family size?
So I walk over to her, friends, and I think I literally said something along the lines of like, so I came to have lunch with my girl.
Oh,
Jay. And she goes, yeah, I know.
Oh, Jay.
She gives I'm not your girl.
She said that?
Yeah. I think a couple fat comments, maybe gross in there. And then she goes, so I swear this is a quote. I go, I come back, I leave. Yeah, with that real, that thing, all right, I'm out of here, I guess.
I guess I'm going to go eat my lunch over there under that rain cloud that's only there.
I hope there's still chocolate milk left.
Yeah. You better pray to God that there's still some chocolate pudding left here. I'm going to mow this whole place down.
I'm going to get my trench coat.
Yeah.
So I go, as I take about 15 steps away, and I really get that, you know what?
Fuck this.
I'm not going to no chump.
Yeah.
I wore karate, you think this bitch met me. So she
with a spiked wrist collar.
She has to know she can't play me like that.
Yeah.
So
self
I'm
defense,
like,
dog.
This is no big deal. Let me go back there. What Papa Bear's about to do? Go back there.
Yo! White girl with spaghetti last name. You about to get clapped on verbally.
I'm going to go back there. You know what? I'll tell you what. This bitch definitely ain't living the rest of her life with my fucking Dog the Bounty Hunter sunglasses.
Rip the shades off.
You think that's happening? And you're an idiot.
Yeah.
So I go over.
Yeah.
And I go, hey, that's cool. You know what? Give me back my glasses. She goes, and I quote, I microwaved them, faggot. And I walked away again. Microwaved him.
Is this woman a police chief now? Because that needs to be.
No. So here's what's funny.
Is she an NFL coach?
Years ago.
Yeah.
When Cherry Hill Rascal still existed.
I remember. Yeah.
It was one of the first places that would headline me.
Okay.
So I go headline there one day, and she gets word. I don't know. It's through Facebook or whatever it is. She MySpace, whatever it is. She finds out that I'm there. Can I come to a show? Can I, me and my boyfriend and blah, 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 ever come to the show? Of course.
Yeah.
Not even, by the way, this isn't even I'll show her. I'm like, oh, cool. Someone from high school is going to come. This is when we were, again, not only were we in high school many years beyond this.
Yes.
It's just whatever. It's it's fucking, you want to hold a childhood grudge from a thing a girl did to me at fucking 13?
I think a lot of investment, investment bankers do. Yeah. I think there's a lot
12
of
or 13.
There's a lot of guys who are I'm going to make money and treat my wife like shit.
We're young. We're really young. So yeah. I have no thing about it. All I'm thinking in my head is I go, oh man, it's going to be so funny to tell the story on stage. And she was sitting right up front.
Yeah.
And I told,
because I will say, as far as punchlines go, I microwave them, you faggot. Pretty goddamn great.
Oh, pops, dude. Pops.
I mean, literally, she should be a writer.
Hicksworthy.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah. Which Carlin special was that for?
I tell the story. Everyone's laughing. She's laughing. She sinks under the table, kind of jokingly, while it's happening. Went all over. She goes, oh my God. She goes, I forgot all about that. And she goes, that was so shitty of me to do that. I mean it wholeheartedly when I'm going, oh, who gives a shit? Whatever. My cousin Vicky, who is straight up South Jersey.
Yeah.
Philly, South Jersey Philly chick. Yeah. South Philly chick, actually, is what she really is. Comes up to me and goes, she goes, why are you talking to that fucking bitch? I go, what? She goes, why are you talking to that bitch? She goes, she fucking called you a faggot and you think back in school and you're talking to her now? I go, Vicky, why?
We're adults.
We're goddamn adults. You want to hold a grudge from 20 years ago?
Yeah.
On something that was very trivial and sort of innocent at the end of the day, which is but they were shitty to me. Big deal.
You know what?
Who cares? And I'm telling you, with Janessa, she came out, and I just wanted some acknowledgement. I don't care if she was yeah, you were really, really into me. I really just couldn't have disregarded you more. And that wouldn't have been my thing to be yeah, what the fuck was with that, you bitch? It would have been way more about I was oh, yeah, no, I know. It was ridiculous. It was
Yeah, that's the whole reason you got upset is because it almost is deleting the fact that it ever happened. You're why? Please just acknowledge that it happened. If I were to see Jeannie Adams or Terry Cracchiolo or Stephanie Holmes, I would just want to be like, yeah, I was in love with you in high school, and you probably, A, either didn't know, or B, I mean, didn't say, I microwaved your glasses, you faggot. That never happened to me.
You
but
grow up.
She'd be like, yeah, you asked me to dance like a fucking moron. But I'm just saying, it's the lack of acknowledgement that really...
Well, just like, no, I think this is not... I mean, that's a thing that
you know
happened.
What, though? No, I like what your cousin Vicky says. Let's go after him. Let's just start mowing down all these bitches that treat... Lauren West, 7th grade, asked her out. She only said yes because I asked her face-to-face.
Didn't really want to.
Didn't want to go out with me. And all of her, she was the hot girl with all the popular kids. And I was just like, and then all of her friends kept coming up to me the next day. By the way, that night, I'm like, at dinner with Trish, I'm like, you know what? I think I want a port wine after dinner. You know, it's going to start settling the stomach. And almost the exact same thing. For a night, I'm like, this is the best. First period, all of her friends start walking up to me like, did Lauren break up with you yet? And I'm like, oh no.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Bottom drops out. Multiple, all of her friends at different times being like, did Lauren break up with you?
You're the last one to know you're single.
Yep. And then she was like, I don't think you should go out. And then someone told me, it was like, and then one of her shitty friends goes, it's only.
She goes out constantly.
She only goes out. She only went out with you because you asked her face to face. So I wrote, so check this shit out. 7th grade. I am fired up. I do the old school version of a Yelp review and write a letter to her calling her shallow, saying that she didn't care about other people's feelings.
That's great.
That she should have the spine to stand up and say that she did want to go out with me. I'd respected her more if she would have said no. I write her this eloquent long email. She gets it. I find out, takes it to math class.
Shows everybody.
Reads it. The teacher reads it to her and 5 of her friends. It was a young teacher. So, Miss Colseth, you're listening to this? Suck my dick. Hit the Tupac. Hit the Tupac. Can't see me. I'm calling them all out. I'm going to come clap on you, mother. I'm coming back for all y'all bitches breaking my heart.
You know what I did for Janessa?
What'd you do?
Broke total bro code for this chick.
Like, all right.
She worked at West Coast Video.
Oh, yeah.
In my house.
Okay. Video stores, big job. You can go, you can hang out, you can flirt a lot.
Yeah. She worked there.
Yeah.
TJ Weinstock, a kid I went to school with, dated her. We were one of the cool kids who dated. She dated all the cool dudes. Dates her for a couple weeks, whatever. I guess they probably made out. I don't think they were fucking. I mean, I think everyone was too young to be fucking. Maybe they were, but it was unbeknownst to me. She goes, so afterwards they break up or whatever, and whatever the reason was, and he's like, we're at his house one day, and he's just going through, his like, yeah, so me and, like, Janessa totally, like, broke up, and he's going through this whole thing. He's like, yeah, it's like, who even cares, right? It's like that, he's like going like that fat bitch, he's like, and he goes, eat another hamburger, you fat bitch. Who cares?
And, like, fuck off.
And I'm just taking, no, I'm definitely doing like that, yeah, right, tub of shit. But in my heart of hearts, I'm like, I'm like, are you saying these mean things to her?
Stop!
So I go to her and do the, you really shouldn't have dated TJ.
Oh,
because, you know, he said, when you guys broke up, he was like, and here's, in my mind, I'm telling her, and she's going to go, that's why you're the one for me.
Dude.
All I'm doing is telling a teenage girl that someone called her fat and told her a cheeseburger behind her back.
You basically gave her body issues that day.
She doesn't have any, she's just crushed. She's just devastated by this news.
All that happened to her is that this guy that sometimes is nice to her.
Came and went.
This guy, yeah, it's Jay. Came and told her that the guy that she was probably in love with was like, called her a fat, oh, look who's wearing orange and standing right behind you.
Get the fuck out of town.
Old Ben in his orange. Of course, he's got a fucking orange jacket.
No, he does. He came here right from directing Cars around an accident.
Or he was unloading a flight from Delta LaGuardia. Baggage handler jacket.
So I tell her.
Yeah, so that's basically all you did.
She just melts down and just gets upset about it.
And doesn't do anything for you.
No, of course, what does she do? She tells him that that happened, and he comes looking for me. And what's so funny was...
What happened?
Usually I was a big kid in school.
Yeah.
And I fought a little bit in school. I shouldn't say, I fought a bunch, actually. I was in a lot of goofy after-school fights.
Yeah.
And so I don't think anyone thought I was like a pushover, like,
Yeah.
I mean, it definitely wasn't like a let's go fight kid either, but it just got, it was so funny. He came to me in the hallway and he's kind of like, yo, man, what the fuck was that basically? He's like, why would you tell her I said that, man? What would you do about that? And I'm like, I said that, like, I don't know, man, you should have said it, I guess. I went to that. And he goes, and my instinct was just to kind of go because I felt like I had no I had no excuse for myself.
Yeah, yeah, you just completely ratted out this guy.
Yeah, he goes, what the fuck was that about, dude? Why would you, that's fucked up, dude.
And,
I went right to like, I'm like, what's up? I mean, we're going to fucking do something about that? And he goes, no, man, it's just, that's fucking a shitty thing to do. And I was like, I had nothing. It was a totally dumb fucking thing. I don't think it ended our friendship, even me and TJ, but like.
But you know what's funny about that? That
should have, man. That was a funk move. But my point just being all these things.
Hold on. But
that was a running through line of high school.
But that hurt more than getting punched. Is TJ being like, I just didn't want you to do that.
Yeah, of course. You're like, I am now the faggot I was called a year ago in lunchroom.
Maybe she should have melted my glasses.
Everyone, just go melt my glasses.
Does anyone want to take a whip at my dick? Someone, people. Well, we got to take a break.
We got to take a break. Oh, when we come back, I promise you, Brandy from Texas, you're going to be our first call. It.
Oh. Yeah, that's right, Miss Colson. Reading that letter to all the popular kids in seventh grade, making fun of me behind my back. The longest bus ride home.
Oh, Samantha Montevani, I made a run at your hoe ass, too.
Yeah.
And you gave me nothing because you only dated niggas with mustaches.
Oh, Ava Vecchi breaking up with me after 2 days together. Carly Hendricks didn't even let me get a kiss. Blamed it on a cold.
Oh, shit. Kim Kropinski had her brother tell me that I was too fat to date in front of all my friends.
Jeannie Adams saying yes to going to homecoming, then getting a boyfriend 2 weeks later so I couldn't make a move. You know what happened.
Oh, you bitches is on blast!
Yeah.
Janessa, recognize next time. Crackle, crackle, motherfucker.
And now back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, yeah, it's the bonfire. It is Monday with the Cars. I'm all goosed up for some Cars music. That is hello again.
Yeah, why are you all goosed up for some Cars?
Real quick, because I don't want to lose our topic, but I will say, outside of my house, I live in the East Village.
Yeah.
Robot toy store thing next to me.
Yeah, right next to you.
Who walks in? Rick motherfucking Ocasek today.
What?
He goes in, I wait awkwardly, smoking cigarettes for him to come back out. I give him the old... It's one thing about being in, like, entertainment at all. You do kind of know how to do that. I mean, some people, I guess, still don't. But, I mean, I'm very, like, I was like, pardon me, my friend. I go, would it be a weird thing to ask if you're Rick Ocasek? And he goes, I am indeed, man. And I went up and shook his hand. I was like, I'm a big fan of yours, man. I go, I'll let you get back to your day, dude.
That's the way to go.
And almost like where he was kind of, like, stalled of, like, are we going to do more? And I was like, but apparently he goes there a lot to that place. Okay. So, like, now we'll have another thing and it'll be fine.
Yeah, you can say hi to Rick.
Yeah.
With this plane blasting.
But man, when he came in, I was like, oh yeah, the fucking Cars, dude.
Great band.
Ooh. Oh, let that roll.
Bow, bow, bow. So pretty much the whole entire hour was us talking about old crushes that we had growing up that inevitably kicked our dicks in emotionally, sometimes physically, verbally, in Jay's case.
Verbally? Lost a good pair of glasses that day.
Yeah, he did. To maybe high heat. Maybe popcorn setting.
This is before popcorn setting. This is crank knob.
Oh, crank knob.
You just pick your mints on a crank knob.
Hey, go in between 3 and 4 just to melt those Oakleys. They're not Oakleys.
Ooh.
They're Folkleys.
Ooh, pump that up, Lou.
Hello. Hello again.
Can't argue with the Cars, dude.
No, you can't.
You can forget about the Cars once in a while.
For years.
But then someone pops on the Cars, and you're like, right, the fucking Cars. Rick Ocasek in the Cars. So cool to meet him. Guy was married, maybe still is, to Paulina, the model, Paulina Poroskova. Am I saying that right?
Nailed it.
Dude.
And he likes to build machines.
And apparently he's also a robot maker.
He's a robot, yeah. He's Geppetto for robots.
Still older, still had long hair. Fingernails painted black. Dug that.
Okay.
That was kind of cool.
Like,
I was in. We're going to have to wait for Brandy from Texas to call back again because she is not on the horn anymore. We keep losing her. I'm so sorry, Brandy. We're going to take you right now, but you're on priority here. But we have...
Wait, hold on real quick, though. Mm-hmm. Do you know the Cars are going to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 2016?
Are they going this year?
That's what
I might try to go. I might try to go to the Barclays for that. I mean, now that me and him are boys.
Yeah, you guys hang out together. Merkface, is that your information?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I call him Ro.
Call who, Ro?
Rick Ocasek.
Oh, cool. I thought you gave Merkface a new name. I was like,
No, Merkface. You don't change Merkface.
You don't change it if it's working.
You don't break something's not fixed.
You don't change it.
We have Michelle, and I'm happy about this. Michelle, Minnesota. I'm excited. I'm assuming Michelle's a girl, and I do want to hear...
Michelle, hi!
...the girl version of this.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Hey, good. Michelle.
How are you?
Hey, good. Love the show.
Thank you.
So I got a good one. I always had a crush on my cousin's best friend. His name was Travis. He was my unicorn.
Okay.
In love with this kid.
How old were you?
14, probably.
Nice. As I'm guessing, as the guys that always had girls crushing on them, did he have abs?
No. This is straight ginger. I don't know why I had a crush on him.
Oh, this is Minnesota, dude. You need a guy for warmth in Minnesota.
Hey, now.
Yeah.
Well, I think I had a crush on him just because he didn't have a crush on me back.
Ah, oh, classic.
You know?
Fair.
I know, right?
Can I ask you this, Michelle? Michelle, a couple preemptive questions. Were you one of the hot chicks in high school?
Well, to be totally honest with you, I didn't know I was hot, but I'm pretty fucking hot.
Nice. Okay, that's okay. Fair. Bonfire, the Bonfire at SiriusXM.com if you want to give us a look at that face.
Perfect.
But we'd love to see. But I mean, I'm asking that simply because that wasn't any sort of a dig in any way, I hope you know. But it was. I was asking, were you one of the hot chicks in school? And
no, I was.
Was your mind at 14 years old, though, were you like, did you have like, I want to fuck this guy? Or were you more of just like, I just want to go to the movies and be boyfriend, girlfriend with him?
You don't want to fall asleep Yeah, do you want to fall asleep on the phone with him?
I don't drink now as an adult. I didn't drink then. I've never done any drugs. I just started screwing people at 14.
Oh!
I figured... I got to do something fun, right?
Wow.
So you were like, I'm going to bone this dude.
Oh, for sure.
There you go. He didn't want to.
And so Travis is just this ginger, no tan because he's in Minnesota.
Obviously.
And he's a ginger.
Yes. I think that, I don't know if he knew that I would have had sex with him. I don't think I was like vocal, like, hey, let's do this. He was my cousin's friend, and my cousin lived a couple cities away, so I didn't see him all the time.
Okay.
But how gassed up did you get? How jacked up were you when you knew you were going to see Travis?
Oh, so much. I mean, like, when I was 14, I was like, when I get my driver's license, the first thing I'm going to do is drive to his house. And hell yes. Got my driver's license. First thing I did, get in my car and drove up to his house.
Wow.
So what happened? You hooked up?
I know, right?
And you hooked up?
Sad. I'm sorry, what?
Did you guys hook up?
No. Oh, no. He was out. Like I said, he was always just kind of too cool for me. Like, he was a little older than me, like 2 years older than me.
That's a huge difference, though. When you're in high school, 2 years is basically he's an adult and you're a child.
Well, I don't look at it like that since I've made a lot of those calls.
Yeah. Never mind.
Turns out those children really liked me.
Well, and so I met my husband when I was 16 that I'm married to now. And so from the time I was 16 till now I'm 33, I've been in a relationship.
Good thing you got those two hoary years at 14 and 15.
Yeah, you really fucking rocked it out for 2 years. You started in fifth gear.
Exactly. Well, I got to start somewhere, right?
Yeah.
So I don't see this guy for 10 years, let's say, right?
Yeah.
I go to my cousin's wedding, and he is his best man. Of course he is, you know?
Old Travis.
Seabird.
Ever.
Yeah. Huh? It's a T-blazer. Yeah. Yeah. He's going to be there.
So my husband and I are at the wedding. It's my cousin's wedding. I, at this point, even have like an 18-month-old kid.
Oh.
And I'm rocking hot still, right?
Yes.
Good body, super thin.
You better be pushing send them an email with all this talk.
Yeah. Yeah. You're really fucking Apollo Creed-ing up.
But come on. I got to give myself props.
Okay. I want to give you props, too. I just want to see.
Well, you know, you guys were talking about asses one day, and I was like, I got to send these guys an email. Yeah, my husband even gave me permission. He's like, hell yeah, send it away.
Good husband.
You guys were talking about asses, and I was like, oh, mine? You can't. Mine's unforgettable.
Well, this is our last episode before... is our last live.
No, we do 20, the 30th.
No, before Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want us to have a Christmas present, Michelle? You want us to have a good Christmas? And send your butt.
All right.
All right,
I'll send it.
So... You're at your cousin's wedding.
Yep. We go on the receiving
old ginger,
line.
Old Ginger T is rocking best man.
Yep, in the receiving
line.
T-Reds? Haven't seen him.
T-Reds.
I'm sorry. So I haven't seen him in 10 years, right? And walking on the receiving line, shaking everyone's hand, standing next to my husband, I look Travis right in the face, and just word diarrhea just pours out. And I just didn't even try. Just looked at him straight in the face and said, oh, my God, you're fat and bald, and just started laughing. And then I felt really bad.
Yeah, you just went and got to be the mean to him that you felt he was to you, but he wasn't mean to you. He just didn't get it.
Wasn't totally, You're right. He wasn't, but it just came out because I was so surprised.
Wait, hold on. Were you drunk? Were you like half in the bag when you did this?
No, I don't drink.
Oh, my God, I forgot.
That's why I don't drink.
So you just write to his face in your Minnesota accent. You go, you got fat and bald.
Great face, and I was like, oh, man.
Oh, it's oofta. You got fat.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
Oh, gosh. Oh, you're just a little bit of a landmaster.
I can't believe I wasted time caring about a melting pumpkin like you.
I can't believe I flicked my bean to you. You're like a pile of mashed potatoes.
Oh, fat and bald. I still remember it because I felt really bad.
Yeah, then he had to go to a dominatrix and get his balls stepped on.
But you know, but my thing, especially with Melissa Patrizio, Jeanette Faragelli, it wasn't even that I was so, I'm not gunning to have a thing, and I don't want to tell them that they're not as good as they were in high school. It's got nothing to, I want to, it's like, let's just acknowledge that we're all adults now. You know what it is? It slid me back, Michelle, my situations, because what it was I thought we were in a place where, actually, Melissa Patrizio was pretty cool about it. Afterwards, she kind of laughed. She goes, oh my God, did I do that? I'm so sorry. And I'm like, who cares? It's fine. But the lack of acknowledgement I got made me feel trivialized. When I was kind of going like, hey, I'm so past that being a thing that would happen to me.
Yeah.
That I'm like, isn't it funny like how I just pined after you and puppy dogged you around? She's like, yeah. She almost had like a, what? You did? It's like, I'll come the fuck on.
Yeah. Now, Michelle, for you, did your husband know all about this? Did your husband watch this reaction?
Yeah, he was standing there. And of course, he's just going, Michelle, stop. Shut up.
Yeah, your husband's a good dude.
Yes, when he sends butt pictures, probably let you get a makeup bang with that fat ginger kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I don't know if my husband would be a big fan of that.
But. Well, yeah, I mean, the man has his fucking limitations. I get it. He's the father of your children. Good God, have some respect for the man.
Does he draw the same lines I draw? No.
No.
But that's all right.
Jay really draws his lines in pencil. So he can erase them and change them and wear how he's.
I'm not letting my girl get gangbanged. Wait, they're all black guys?
Man. Well, Michelle, it sounds like you're in a good relationship now.
Oh yeah, and I mean, yes, absolutely. It was just kind of one of those things where
so it's
he
good.
Was always my unicorn, and then he Facebook friended me, and I was like, oh bam, who's it now?
But see, this is the difference between men and women, because men just get shit on in that situation, mm-hmm. and he was just slightly disinterested, and then she fucking jihaded him.
The best part was he was across the room, and he's like, oh, Michelle, it's my best buddy's
my cousin.
She was always so cool, and you're like, you're fat and bald.
Yeah, he's at his wedding, he's like, oh, dude, is that Michelle?
And then someone goes, ah, she's just drunk, and they go, I don't drink.
And I want you to know this, I'm saying this perfectly clear and sober, you're a fat piece of shit, and your head is bald.
I am stone sober, and you have become really ugly.
I legitimately could operate heavy machinery right now and not get in any trouble, and I'm looking you dead in your eyes, what some people call the windows to your soul, to tell you, you fat hunk of garbage, I hate you.
Travis, you are one ugly fuck. Now, to prove my point, ZYXW.
I'm going to walk in a straight line. Finger to the nose. Finger to the nose. You have no hair. Finger to the nose. Michelle, thank you very much for calling in.
Yeah, no problem.
That's awesome. You know, Michelle, it's just, it's different.
But
it's
dude,
always going to be different.
So here's the thing. When I started comedy in Tucson, I had a crush on the girl that worked at the ticket door. I haven't told you the story. Did I tell you the story? About the girl I was in love with?
Maybe not.
And I brought her a signed Coheed and Cambria poster?
No, but I love it.
Yeah, hey, Murkface is laughing because it's music he doesn't
Murkface
like.
Murkface has his pants unbuttoned. He's combing through the emails for Michelle's pictures. Michelle, send those shits now. You have permission.
He's got his hand over his wiener like it's a draw.
Just so you know.
High noon.
If you're going to do butt shots, you got to do them straight on and bent over. You know why, Soder? Because you get a little butt shot on those.
I just want you just dancing to some Sean Paul.
Not me.
I want some jiggle factor.
What was the song the girl was dancing up on the thing for? What was a...
For what? Oh,
what
Aaliyah.
What was Stephanie Holmes?
Aaliyah. Are you that somebody?
Oh, are you that somebody? Yeah, let's get a video of you. Somebody.
And then go, you can dance with me. Let's just solve the problem.
Am I possible?
So I was in love with this girl that took tickets at Laughs, the comedy club in Tucson. Love with her.
What year was this?
2003.
You're doing comedy.
Yeah, 2004.
Oh.
I'm 21 years old.
Oh, okay.
And I got
wow.
I got fucking 300 kicked in the heart at 21 years old. She
You're
fucking
not good enough!
This is laughs! she kind of looked like Jessica Alba. Her name's Jenna. And she, I was like,
young Jessica Alba?
Young Jessica Alba.
Like, talking Alias?
Yes, we're talking Idle Hands. So she's working the ticket booth, and then before every open mic, I'm just babbling at her like a fucking lunatic. Every time I come in, I'm like trying to be funny with her, sure. And I'm making her laugh. Other comics are hitting on her, and I'm like, those fucking maniacs, right? And
ooh, the vultures are out tonight, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
I play the same move.
And you could smoke inside.
So I currently do that move.
I'd light a cigarette while she was talking, like to be like cool, like, oh yeah, so you
just come over here crushing a butt before I go in and do my shit.
It's gotta get off my mind. Just gotta work my art, my craft.
All those extra cigarette noises.
What am I gonna talk about tonight? Homeless people and how they're crazy. Because I was just a hack.
You finished the blow?
Yeah.
What are you talking about? Subways, airplane food, shit like that.
I don't know, maybe about these two unnecessary wars we're in.
We got a Bill Cosby impression I'm trying to work on.
Maybe Andrew Dice Clay if he was running the country right now. So, I just made a cigarette without a filter. Pick it out of your tongue.
You're dicing it?
Yeah.
Oh, who's in there? Is that guy hitting on you all night? You just do the arm around the head, slap cigarette.
I gotta go take Colleen.
What's her name?
Jenna.
Jenna, what the fuck are you doing here, you pig, with those big fat tits?
And those brown eyes.
Oh. Like a good geesh. Good geesh. Yes. Oh, that's two right there for you.
So I go up there and I'm just babbling like a lunatic, and she's like, dude, this is how much I liked her. This is an adult how much I liked her. So this is a child, almost like a teenage crush.
You made her a handmade card for Christmas?
Dude, worse than that. She tells me she's moving to L.A. She's like, I'm moving to L.A. with my family. And she has a boyfriend who lives out in L.A. And I was like trying to wreck that, just being a real piece of shit.
Trying to wreck that?
Yeah.
It's too far.
Why is he's out there? You got to date someone here.
It's not going to work out. Says the guy who tried a very similar long-distance relationship.
Just had that fail with a longer distance. So anyways.
Do as I say, not as I do.
So she is, she's moving. And I'm like, I got to throw a Hail Mary. I got to be like, I'm in love with this girl. I get my roommate's girlfriend, who kind of looks like her. Just they both have long brown hair. They kind of look like each other.
Vaginas.
Yeah.
Two nips.
Get my roommate's girlfriend to go to the DMV and get a new driver's license that I give to her as a fake ID. Because I was 21 and she was 20. Mm. Got her a fucking fake ID, like a legit.
That's your flowers I did when I was 9.
But that's an adult.
Effort. Same
I,
effort. Though,
I mean, yeah. A Herculean effort. I had to drive my roommate's girlfriend to the DMV, wait with her at the DMV, make sure she
break
got
a federal law.
I mean, I'm not admitting that. You know, that's not what I did. I didn't actually do that.
Well, that girl did.
That girl, well, yeah, you know. Or it could be a fabricated story for the sake of radio.
Sure.
But
sure,
let's just sure, say sure. It's not.
License number 718.
G10987.
Victor.
T is in dog. I get her this, and she's like, oh, mom. She like comes to my house, and I'm like, I thought I was so cool. I remember exactly. I was watching Thursday Night Football, and I'm drinking Rolling Rocks. And I'm like, I'm a raging alcoholic. So I'm drinking like three while she's there.
That's a Denver story.
And I'm smoking bowls.
Mm.
Thinking that she's going to think this guy's awesome. Look how much he's consuming.
Oh, you're killing it.
She moves to L.A. We still talk on the phone. She tells me, she's like,
those are the worst because it's too late. But you know, though, it's kind of late. Like you're about to lay the charm on it.
She keeps calling me back. So we keep talking. And I'm like, I look at this is how dumb I was. This is, again, a 21-year-old man. I rented a car and saw that USC was playing Arizona, which is where I went to school. I talked my buddy into going to a game, USC versus
this
Arizona.
This is literally the story of Road Trip.
Is this really?
The movie Road Trip.
Oh.
Was this girl Amy Smart?
Yes. What?
Was the guy driving Stifler?
Yes! Sean William Scott? No, so it's just me by myself, and my buddy comes from Vegas. We go to L.A. She's a big Coheed and Cambria fan. I get her a signed poster by the band because I worked at a radio station.
Great.
Had access. Full signed poster sitting next to me in the passenger seat. I drive to L.A.
So you can go in the carpool lane.
Obviously. If Claudio's with me.
There's a whole band here, man.
He has his five signatures.
What seems to be the problem, officer? I'm hanging with him.
Stand away, sweet shooter.
We're passing all of the traffic.
A good Coheed fucking highway traffic. So I get to L.A. and I call her. And by the way, the week before, she's like, she does this move. If you come to L.A., you have to stay at my place at least one night, which could get me literally to punch through iron. I was ready. I was so jacked up.
Did your boner hit the wheel and almost make you veer off the road?
It did. It flipped, and then it came back on. And I was like,
oh, oh, yeah.
Oh, we're okay.
Got it.
So I drive to L.A., call her once, voicemail, leave a voicemail, get to L.A., hang out. My buddy comes in, a girl we went to high school with, we're staying at her house. I get obscenely drunk. Call her again. Doesn't pick up. I leave a drunk message. Next day, nothing.
Thought we were going to boo foo tonight. I drove all this way.
Hey, it's Dan.
Joey and Cambria running passenger.
Hey, what's up? It's Dan Soder. Just sitting here holding the Coheed poster. I should be about balls deep about a half hour ago.
Do you have your phone next to the radio playing this song? Yeah.
Hey, this is song makes me think of you. This line right here.
I sniper. And I shoot. And you run. The birds are sampled.
You know Lewis? You know, Lewis went to high school with them.
No, he went to prom with them.
Oh, prom with them.
Not with him. They went to prom. They both had dates. They were all in the same limo.
Never calls me back. Never hear from her again.
That's it.
Cold shoulder.
Stay with me.
Half
you
hour.
Fucking drive to Los Angeles.
Spent a whole weekend. Money I don't have.
Wow.
Comedy Central's The Half Hour comes out. 2013.
Oh, I love this.
Facebook message.
Now give me the other Coheed song, that Welcome Home. This is the music for this part of the story. Yeah. Revenge Coheed and Cambria.
I am at the Sacramento Punchline in the hotel for the Sacramento Punchline, smoking a cigarette outside. Just ripping a Camel Light. Let me check Facebook. Oh, there's a couple numbers on the messages.
And what do you think one of those messages would be?
Hey, loser. Saw you on TV. What you been up to?
I just imagined a Coheed poster burning somewhere. Oh, me? I'm just updating my IMDb.
Got some things in the works. Whore.
Oh, that's weird. I'm just writing a script with the co-head writer of SNL.
He approached me.
It's an animated. I'll probably get created by executive producer credit.
Bitch.
And then it just like, it just got weird. Like,
that was so fun.
But it was one of those things where, but I did get the acknowledgement of like, oh yeah, I was like kind of an asshole. And you're like, but I never brought that story up to her.
Did you even ask the thing? Like, what was it?
I had a girlfriend.
You kind of want to, and then you're also just like, fuck. You almost want to show. I'm like, I don't care.
I didn't care. And I honestly didn't care.
I believe you.
To the point where it was like, okay. And I found out she had two kids. So it was like, what am I stepping in as a stepdad?
Dude.
You're giving me a stepdad role?
Dude, I've had girls who I was not interested in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Even like, I was like, I don't even want to fuck this chick. She's really nice, but I don't even want to fuck her.
Yeah.
In my life, that I've been like, I get the thing of like, and they're kind of like up your shit.
Yeah.
And you're like, I don't want to really do, you know what I mean? I don't want to do this. And you kind of don't do it. And they get the hint maybe after a while, or they don't. But whatever it is, that happens. So I understand. So again, when you said, when you reapproach these,
yeah,
you feel like you're so approaching with like, we're kids and who gives a shit?
Oh my God.
It's all thing. But you're going like, what are you talking about? You fucking know what I'm talking about.
If she denied my oversized Cobra Kai t-shirt and my Caesar cut,
she would never.
Drinking fat tires and smoking cigarettes.
I wish you would try.
Oh man. I wish it would happen. Should we take another break?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, when we come back, I want to talk to Renee in Texas because he says he was humiliated by a girl. And I am enjoying that, everybody. It is the Bonfire.
We'll be right back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder. And now back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Hello. It's your friend.
Oh, it's my boy Rick Ocasek in the Cars. It's Monday with the Cars and the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm your host, Big Jokers, and that's your host, Dan Soder.
Hi.
We're hanging here, man. We are laying it out tonight.
Can't stop, won't stop. Christmas week. Presents I'm a little, coming.
To be honest with you, and again, here's the thing. This is where the ego shots come in on a weird thing.
Yeah.
We got, let's just lay it. We got billboards in two cities.
Coast to coast, baby.
The show is national.
It's a national. It's even international.
We brought over audience from all the bigs.
Established radio shows are O&A, now listening to us.
O&A, Ron and Fez, Bennington
Ooh,
Show, Howard
it
Stern.
It feels so good.
Successful podcasts. We're out there.
Multiple podcasts.
Several TV appearances.
Television
each.
Comedy specials.
And not one of these fucking people we're talking about is listening at all to even call in and give their side of this.
I went from Ashley to Nash to the class, you know.
God damn, man.
You know, they still be in the suburbs, not caring. You know what I mean? I'm going back to Aurora tomorrow. You
Gotta
know what
find
I mean?
A girl who's into a guy with titties.
I'm going to drive around Mission Viejo. Look at all those places I didn't get jerked off. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
303, women.
Feel your dog piece.
Yeah, no, they don't care. No one ever cares.
They don't give a shit. You know what?
People that we want to care don't care.
I want another. Jay Michigan, we're going to get to, but I want to. That's a whole. That's a deviation off what we're talking about here, but I want to hear that story. But now we have Nikki in Minnesota. I want to talk to Nikki in Minnesota here because we got another girl take on this. I feel like the girl takes, we're all just a step away from being. If a girl. Girls generally. Don't have to, and even Christine said something before that kind of made me think about that. The thing is, if you go, oh, I'm not getting the guys that I'm crushing on, as a girl, you lower your standards a little more, you're guaranteed dick if that's what you're combing for.
Well, it's like boxers.
You're guaranteed. As a dude, the thing was like, I'm getting shot down by the fucking upper class, you know, like the high level hot chicks that look great. Titties, ass, gorgeous faces, and then you start going like, "Well, I'll go for like the cuter, whatever." And then I would try. Then I would try like we said before earlier, the sweatpants girls, the girls who aren't all about getting dolled up. But you're like, you see the diamond in the rough. Which actually, my long term girlfriend, from me being 17 to 22, was that
nice.
I found the girl, like, and then what happened? When I'd bring her to the pool party. Everyone would be like, "What the fuck?" And I'm like, "I know, right? Aren't those dumb jeans?
Scouted her probably.
Aren't those baggy jeans and t-shirts and that ponytail all these years was
all
that shit.
A couple bumps and excuses me feeling her through those sweatpants. You're like, oh, but hey, no, oh, there you go,
game player.
Well, see, the difference
but a girl can lower that. The guy can't just lower and make it happen for sure. Sorry,
that's what I was gonna say. Is women, it's like boxers. They can just drop a weight class and start knocking motherfuckers out.
Yeah.
For men, it's like not being in the NFL. What, are you going to go play Arena League? You can't do that.
Probably not.
No, you're going to quit. You're going to open a car dealership in the place where you played college ball.
Absolutely.
Or walk around with Ben Energy and just wear a bunch of orange.
So, Nikki in Minnesota?
Yeah.
How are you, sweetie?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm going. Nikki's got a voice like we called her.
Thanks for calling. Yeah. She's going to do it. She's going to go. She goes, I really don't like your guys' shows, so...
Yeah. Oh my god, you guys have a radio show? That's so stupid. I'm like, hey Jay, should we not do the radio show anymore?
Yeah, she's gonna get to... She goes, by the way, I haven't left once this hour, faggot.
I wanted to see what your Abby skills are like.
You wanted to what?
I wanted to see what your Dear Abby skills are like, so you can give me some advice.
Sure. Oh, you have a current crush story.
Yeah. And I feel like a jerk.
How old are you?
37.
Okay.
Perfect.
All right. We're playing. We're playing ball.
I'll give it a whirl.
Well, I'm married. I've been married a few years. And just to give a little background, I have a really pretty face, but I am a bigger girl, like Melissa McCarthy, probably at her.
Okay.
Not quite her biggest, but bigger. But there is a guy that I work with, and he's shown some interest in me, and I like him. And me being a bigger girl, my husband's a bigger guy.
Okay.
And he has problems physically with us actually, you know, being able to be completely intimate together.
Okay.
And he works for a railroad, so he's gone for sometimes months at a time. And, you know, being a woman in her 30s, I feel like a freaking teenage boy.
And Nikki, is this guy and the guy who's laying it on you at work, giving you the rap, is he a guy, you find him really good looking?
He's not necessarily really good looking. He's not bad looking. personality wise, I guess I just feel attracted to him, and we, you know, have good conversations and get along, and he makes me laugh.
Okay. Gotcha.
And your husband's kind of removed already from the situation.
Yeah. But I mean, he's wonderful. I mean, just a wonderful person. So that's why I feel so bad, you know?
Your husband is.
Well, he's a wonderful person, but he doesn't get you going the way the guy at work gets you going.
Right.
Well, the guy at work is new. But I'm saying more, when you say he has a hard physical time with intimacy, that's a weird way to clean it up.
That's a great way. It's so close to the Christmas episode, too.
Yeah. With, you know, copulation.
Absolutely. Performing the act of coitus.
Yes. He has a problem, physically a problem, because of his size, his weight. He can't, or he's just not into it, you mean?
Because of his size.
Okay.
Because of his size. Go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, he is very attracted to me, and he really tries hard, and, you know, we have good sex life, not, you know, actual physical, you know, not copulation or... Yeah, whatever. But, you know, we do other things, and it works. It's just...
Okay. maybe some food play involved in there? Like, put his favorite sandwich by your cooch or something?
Just rip it. Yeah. A good meatball
hand. I do like food, but I don't like putting it on my body.
Okay, yeah, no, absolutely.
We might just put three meatballs in your cooch.
And you're like, go get me dessert. Go get him, boy. Go get him. Go get him, boy. Go get
him.
Go get him.
You know what? I mean, look, if I was giving Dear Abby advice on this, here's the thing. My Dear Abby is a fucking person who gives advice. It's going to be offbeat.
She's a woman with a possible blood disease.
It's going to be offbeat, Nikki, this advice. But here's my, and I want to each give our own.
Okay.
Yeah, I want Soder to give his, I want to give mine. Soder, give yours first. You want to give yours? Do you have your set or
Yeah,
no?
Absolutely. So my question to this is, Nikki, you're attracted to the guy at work.
Mm-hmm.
Are you still in love with your husband?
Yeah, I still love him. And I wouldn't want to get divorced or anything.
You
like
don't want to get divorced.
All.
You want to stay married. However, you also... So basically, you want your cake and eat it too. You want to stay married while also having sexual relations with this guy at work, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
And I will say, my husband and I had a conversation.
So you've breached...
He said that... I did tell him that I was worried that I may cheat on him. I was honest with him. I'm not the kind of person that can hide things.
Yeah, no, you're a good person. And what did you say? What did he say to that?
He said that he would never want to lose me, and he really stepped up his game on trying to be more romantic and show me more attention when he's home, because it was, I mean, you know, he works really hard. He works 80, 90 hours a week, and when he comes home, all he wants to do is relax. So,
yeah,
you know,
I'm gonna say.
But I was gonna say also, he did say that he would be okay with me being with a girl if he got to watch.
Well, of course. I mean, that's every.
Really?
What a saint!
And at one point, he did say that if it ended up where I was with a girl when he wasn't around, that he wouldn't necessarily have been too upset. But
of course, he wouldn't be upset at all, because it's the other. It's the threat of outside dick. It's what all men. It's what all men fear.
Okay.
I'm going to say something, and I don't mean to be coarse or too curt or anything like that, but just from hearing all your different elements to the problem, my initial reaction is approaching a weight loss so that you guys can start having sex. Changing your diet,
and that's the other thing.
Exercise.
We have been.
Okay. Yeah.
And I have lost weight, and I'm on you know, a medication that helps with my appetite, and I've lost weight, and that
because I just feel like my advice is all based on the fact that if you and your husband started having sex, maybe this crush would wash down or wouldn't be as intense, because you guys would be having sex, therefore alleviating that pressure that even you said you're like a young teenage boy right now.
Yeah.
So my thought process is, if you guys lose weight and start having sex, it won't be. It won't be as intense, this between you and your guy at work, because, you know, you'll have sex and you'll blow off that steam and then be like, maybe, you know, because clearly you've already said it. You love your husband. He's a good dude. You don't want to get divorced. He doesn't want to lose you. He was even trying to go to his extent and be like, you can be with another girl. There's no way he's going to be cool with you fucking this dude at work. So my advice is try, and this is such fucking boring advice, wheat bread of advice, but it's honestly the only way that I can empathetically be like, I just would try to lose weight and have sex with your husband. That I know it's not like the easiest, sexiest answer.
Is that your Reader's Digest advice?
It is. It's just both you guys both go on a diet, start losing weight together, start feeling that sense of accomplishment, and then start banging it out.
Cool.
With the guy that you got a ring on your finger with.
Can I do mine now?
Yeah, Jay's going to give you some real roller rink manager advice.
Now that Soder called you and your husband fat.
She said he physically can't have sex.
My apologies.
I'm a monster.
Well, we are fat. We know that.
Nikki, I'm a big guy myself. No one's passing judgment over here, baby cakes.
I hate you.
I bet you are all good, Puddin'.
Cool stepdad vibe.
Here's what I'm thinking. This is what I would say. Now, Nikki, you're in your I don't think any of this is going to get squashed by you just trying to find an awesome thing with your husband. How long have you been with your husband for?
Almost 4 years.
Okay. He's having sex problems. You really want to fuck this guy. You're 37. You are right in your, like, these are your years where you're, like, horny a bunch.
Yeah.
My suggestion would go full tilt. Talk to your husband, because you said you've already said this to him. I'm worried about cheating on you, but I love you. I don't want to get divorced. I don't even want to split up. I don't even want to do things behind your back. What I would say is, like, can we give a whirl to the idea of let me have this guy come over and you could jerk off wife and how hot it would be, and I'll make eye and try to make a situation. I'm telling you, paint a picture of how awesome it's going to be for him to watch you get fucked and stuff. Like, I'm telling you, as a guy, I don't appreciate the idea of that. Go ahead, Dan. You have a question about my advice.
Yes, and I appreciate you not interjecting on my advice.
It's
so
okay.
This is strictly a question.
It's not a problem.
Hypothetically, is this ink in the water? Will this spread to the inevitable collapse of their relationship?
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because
if you want to fuck another.
Because if it was, it was. But if you're coming with complete, I don't want to break up.
Yeah.
But this guy particularly seems to be laying on there. She said he's not like some kind of amazing looker. Look, if you're going to bring in some fucking abs motherfucker to do it, maybe he would have a gripe about
would
that.
Would you mind if I use your giant shirt to wipe myself off?
By the way, he might have a problem. He may end up loving this, Nikki, and that may end up becoming a thing you guys even do from time to time. Maybe you bring in a girl. Maybe you bring in a guy. But open it up. If you're bored of what's happening, it's not going to go away.
Okay.
It's not. I think even with weight loss, it's not going
to
matter.
You don't think weight loss, them getting new bodies on each other.
Can I talk to you as a guy who's lost weight?
Yeah.
My body looks tenfold better probably in clothes. But when I'm undressed, I'm a guy, it looks like a guy who lost weight even.
Okay.
I'm not like flappy and shit at all, but you get what I'm saying? It's like, I still don't take off my shirt and have you go like, whoa, this guy's body's popping. It's
check
like, I'm
out
just,
Jason
I'm just
Pex.
Like, I'm chubby-er instead of fat now.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
I mean,
it's
really
not going to go away, but I'm telling you.
My dumb, innocent advice.
With what you've already said.
My Dr. Oz advice.
I think you've done the most difficult thing already, saying you're having these feelings. Sparking it up as an idea, like, let's just try, and you could always tell him, like, look, if you hate it, maybe we won't do it again. And then if you're going to decide to do it behind his back, it's a thing. But incorporate him, you'd be surprised how he may find that to be like a pretty hot idea if you present it as hot as possible. But you got to be filthy about your description. You got to be like, this is going to be like a fucking low down, like, awesome fucking experience.
What
for
if
us.
He's not into that?
My advice was simply to take a shot at that. Try to be convincing about it, because I think he will have to respect, and you can keep pointing out, I'm not fucking this guy behind your back.
Yeah,
but, and I'm not going to, but I'm telling you, this is a guy who's throwing it at me, sort of, and it's a thing that, like, we can make happen.
Nikki, do you think your husband would be into that?
Probably not.
Yeah, probably not.
Well, I was going to say, with his weight thing, He has like, you know, a problem with food. Like, he's lost weight, but then he'll keep getting it back. And he's been trying for years and years, and he keeps saying he's gonna, you know, do things, and then he really doesn't. And it's kind of a
tell him that the guy from work will also bring over Wendy's bacon Gouda burger.
Good, Paul. Or even or the chicken Asiago with ranch.
My Christ,
I'd let
except one time I bit into one. pulled away from the sandwich.
Don't tell me this.
Five hairs like guitar strings.
Stop it.
From my mouth to the sandwich.
Stop it. I won't let you sully the good name of a chicken Asiago ranch.
Dude, it made me do the, it made me do like the dry
Stop
heaves.
It. I'm already upset about Nikki's relationship. I don't need you piling this on
Nikki,
top of
I'm not worried about your relationship. You have a bump in the road here, but you can always... Sex can always get weirder, which will make things interesting. But you may have to open up your mind to, let, you know, letting some girl lick your butthole while he watches. You know what I mean?
I'm completely open to that.
So,
and that's part of it. I mean, because he is so great, I've gotten over a lot of, you know, self-esteem issues. And I'm starting, even though I am so big, he makes me feel beautiful. And I am opening up about, you know, things that, you know, we watch porn together, and that's something that I was just embarrassed to do. And, you know,
well, yeah, I mean,
it's really gotten better. But.
Maybe you're inching your way towards Jay's resolution.
Yeah.
Nikki, if you're watching porn together, start watching, keyword search the word cuckold in your porn search, which is where the husband, like, films the girl hooking up with other guys,
also
and
known
he
as,
comes in,
yeah,
does some business himself.
Yeah. I really
I'm telling you, you could... You may be able to finagle your way,
but also
into getting him to try just some odd shit
or eat carrots and cut carbohydrates out of your diet.
Listen, I'm not going to tell anybody not to lose weight. It's what you should do. Absolutely, you want to live. You know what I mean? I don't know if you guys have kids or anything, but you
we don't have kids together, but I have three, and that's another thing. He's like their father.
There you go.
Fathers and their biological fathers are. So.
I'm telling. And this guy, what does he do? What's his job?
Works for the railroad.
Oh, he's a railroad guy. This
hey,
guy's
don't.
Into some ski shit.
Oh, you think so?
Oh yeah, dude.
You think he's all in spank wire while he's fixing the tracks that help America run?
I don't know why he wouldn't be. And I'm telling you, Nick, approach him with the
Jerking
idea of
it. It all day.
You'd be surprised out of the gates, Nick. And I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Again, this is nothing's foolproof here. But I think you will be pleasantly surprised to see his, like, the spark up in his eyes just going, like, wow, like, my girl's into some, like, fun, funky sex shit. Like, this
or
might be interesting.
Out.
But you're going to have to find out either way.
You're right. So
you got to find either way because this is something you want to do. And I'm saying, before you do it behind his back, which seems like it's something you want to do, and I'm not telling you not even to do that. I'd be a hypocrite to tell you not to do that. I've done some pretty foul shit in my life, and I'll tell you that I have regretted like a bunch of it for different reasons, not always the person I did it with, but always the person I was hurting in the other end of it.
Yeah.
And getting into a relationship in life where you can get and have that honesty, like, hey, I want to do this, involve yourself in it, I'm telling you, you'd be surprised how he might jump on board with that. And if he doesn't, at least you know where you stand. Then
you
in
go.
Your mind, even if you don't tell him right then and there, in your mind, you kind of already have, like, well, this is probably not going to last forever. And you're 37, so you still have, you said you're losing weight, and you still have all in your 40s to find whatever the fuck you're going to find. You know what I mean? I wouldn't oversweat it, Nikki.
Yeah.
I think you're in a good spot, and it seems like you're a pretty honest, upfront person with what you've already said, so... Drop that hammer. At least there's something in that for him.
Yeah.
I'll bring a girl. How about this? Let's try a couple. Maybe we have a couple coming over. You fuck the girl. I'll fuck the whatever it is. Try some weird shit with him.
See if this dude has a girlfriend.
And if he loves you, it makes you feel pretty. You can kind of tell him, like, well, look, this is kind of like the world how I'm feeling right now. And we'll give us some weird shit a try. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. You'll find out quick.
But let us know what happens, Nikki.
Okay.
Call us back and let us know.
Stay in touch.
Yeah, stay in touch.
Hey, you want me and Dan to come over there and bone you while your fucking husband jerks off?
I mean,
that's cool.
You know what? I'll actually go into your I'll go into your refrigerator. I'll go into your kitchen. I'll start preparing some fun lunches that also taste good.
You don't even have to pay me. You just got to give us promise you'll give us two choo-choo hats to go home with.
I want a choo-choo hat. Jay wants a choo-choo hat. If I can get the overalls of a conductor... Do you guys have the...
I can get you the wooden whistle.
Oh! Yeah, you know what? Done. We're already there.
Jay will take care of your sexual needs. I'll have some fun breakfast and lunch options.
Lube up your sniz and your beehole, because Dan and Jay are coming home for Christmas.
But Dan's only coming to your kitchen to help you live a healthier life. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
And now back to the Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Rick Ocasek in the cars.
That's Jay's new best friend.
It's my boy. We like robot shopping together.
Sirius XM 95. It's Comedy Central Radio. It's The Bonfire. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. We've been talking about heartbreak. We've been giving love advice.
We're really nailing it today.
We're fucking turning a
today
corner.
Today could have been a four-hour show.
It could have been. Guy that's been waiting to tell us this story, one of the last story we're going to get to today on the show, the last
Before we take it, we have to. I can't believe we didn't know.
Just, how did we know? I'm sorry. Melissa.
Michelle.
I'm
Michelle
so
from Minnesota sent her ass.
It's crazy.
First of all, Michelle, in fairness, I asked for face pics. You can send whatever dirty pics you want, and that ass is
insane.
World class.
It is. Exactly, Mark Norman. It is.
I mean,
it's Lowrider Magazine good.
It's fucking wow.
I said it earlier, but I meant it.
Michelle,
this time.
Keep going. Your husband gave you permission. Please. Really turn up the whore juice on this next pictures you sent.
I mean, when you dressed that guy down at that wedding, oh, God, I felt bad for him. But, yeah, send in your tushy to the guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let him see your little rump.
Yeah. Lose the panties is what I would say. But I'm just a piece of shit.
You are.
Don't listen to me. Listen to Dan. But really listen to me.
Listen to him.
Let Dan be the angel on your shoulder, but inside go, you know what? I think I'm going to split lip for these guys.
Not only that, but... And then you can just listen to my advice later to make you feel good, like a warm bath.
Yeah, that's how you clean yourself off after.
Yeah.
You scrub down. You take a crying game shower, in Dan's words.
Yes.
But you let me come in and just tranny fuck your shitter, and we all have a great time.
True that. We were talking about being embarrassed the whole first hour, crushes we've had that spilled over from a show that Jay and I did this weekend in Jersey with the Impractical Jokers. This guy's been waiting to tell us this story for quite some time. Renee in Texas, it's a dude, and he got humiliated by a girl. What's up, man?
Renee.
Hey, what's up?
We've talked
to
Renee.
Up, guys?
Renee, you've called before, right?
Yes, you are the fry. Yeah, we've talked to you before.
Oh, yeah. It's Gambit.
Hells. Yes, that's who it is.
Hells yeah.
Gambit from the X-Men. I apologize. Renee, you have a crush story? You got that fucking accent. How are you not just Sorry.
I was in middle school, seventh grade, and I had a huge crush on this chick. Same grade, everything, but yeah, she was, you know, the quintessential popular kid, head cheerleader, all that, but mad crush on her. Then, you know, I wrote her a secret admirer letter during health class.
Okay.
Gave it to her. Then I wasn't expecting to get anything back. And then I actually got a letter back, which just fucked me up.
How great was that? What did your letter to her say?
Did you lay it all out? Was this like the letter?
Yeah.
Well, no. Basically, I told her, "Hey, you know, I can't tell you who I am because you know if I do that, you know, I'm gonna get laughed at and all that shit." But I like you and everything. I see you every day and everything. I think you're beautiful and all that. And then she wrote back, and I forgot exactly what she wrote, but she told, "Yeah, you should tell me who you are and all this and that." I'm like,
"You shouldn't."
Fuck. I got pumped up, and I was like, this shit might actually work.
No, no.
It might go good.
You know what you did in this dress right there? You know what that was the equivalent of? Of a hawk screeching above, and you're a fucking groundhog in the ground, and you popped your dumb groundhog head out the ground. And you're
exactly.
Like, it's safe. It's safe. I should come out. It's me.
I regretted it. As soon as... I wrote another letter, and I said exactly who I was.
Ooh, I am Rene, the only French exchange student in all of Texas.
Rene?
I talk exactly like Jean-Claude Van Damme. I have a big surprise. Huge surprise.
Come watch me work out in my black underwear.
Yeah. You and your fancy black underwear can go back to Disneyland. Where you give it this
I Muay Thai will be in the Kumite.
Yeah, would you give her blood sport lines? So you wrote her back.
Yeah, I wrote her back. I told her who I was, and things went good for a little bit.
How so? Explain how they went well for a little.
Well, for a little bit, she said, "Oh, thanks for the letter and everything, and all that." And I was like, "All right." They're like, "Shit, this is gonna go good.
Are we going to become pen pals now?"
Yeah, and they're like,
"You of all people should know, I never write handwritten letters
in black silk underwear."
In black silk underwear.
Well, the next day, her friends come up to me and just let me have it.
Oh, what did they say, Renee?
They said, "Don't you ever write her again. Oof. You're way below her class and this and that." I was like, And like I didn't react at first. I was like, whatever. But her friends told their friends, and it just spread through the whole school for 2 years. In middle school, I was a laughing stock.
Why would they laugh at you? Because you showed honest emotion in middle school, which you cannot do because humans are still animals at that point. They have not grown into.
No, it's fine. I tell you, I the Samantha Montavani girl. I said, yeah. I did
Samantha Big Ziti.
Yeah, every one of the hot girls of school, I gave at least a one note shot to.
Okay.
Like, you know what I mean? Where I write him a note?
Dude, I liked your style.
Yeah, I went note. But I signed my notes like a dim wit.
Jay Song.
Yeah. And, son of a bitch, if I was like, I gave it to her and I didn't hear back from right away, which I thought, I was operating on that one, especially. Yeah. No news, good news.
Yes.
And it just like, she like showed people.
Yeah.
That should be another time. Have I ever told you that this is. Fucking! I had to have told you this on the show about the when I plagiarized the song.
No, but man, did you just tease us for when we come back on the 30th?
Can I just do it right now, real quick? It's super short.
Absolutely, Jay.
Deanna Brady. This is a good one too.
That's a great crush name.
Yeah, Deanna Brady. Actually, the same dance where Janessa gave me the cold shoulder bebop move. I ended up taking the dance picture with Deanna Brady, who was there with her boyfriend, Mike Luciani.
Mike Linguini?
Mike Luciani's going on. I've seen him on Facebook recently. He was a kind of a chubby kid too. Good looking though.
CrossFit.
He was a cool, I don't know if CrossFit, no, he's a biker, but like jacked, like weightlifter.
Yeah.
Biker guy, like really. Awesome.
Looking for
he
you.
Looks awesome.
That dance
no, not
picture,
at all. No.
That dance picture motivated him.
They were all so non-threatened by my fat doofness.
Yeah.
So wait, facial hair came into play huge in my world. Yeah. When I was able to get facial hair a little bit, changed my life.
Changed it up.
I just got a big, dumb, fat baby, fat guy face.
Okay.
So.
I think it's cute.
No, now, I grew into my looks, bro.
Yeah, you're talking to a guy with a giant head and a tiny body.
Get stage confidence, bro.
No one wanted to fuck a bobblehead in fucking 10th grade.
Right. Grow into your shit. That's fine.
Blackjack.
I'm okay with it going the way it went.
Yeah.
I'm okay with it. I'd rather the experiences I've had as an adult at making it happen the way it happened versus if I peaked in high school.
Oh,
by far. So,
dude, I think about that all the time.
I'm fine with that. Deanna Brady, though, when she was not with her boyfriend, in fact, they broke up, so I was like, here's my chance. Take a shot at Deanna Brady. And Deanna Brady, if I'm being honest, was not, I thought she was really hot, but not in the elite. Maybe she was. I don't know.
Second round draft pick.
Mid first. She wasn't a lottery pick. I'm talking all lottery picks here.
Oh, wow.
She was first round. She was a hot chick. Okay. Without a doubt, a hot chick. Very Philly. That's the best way to put it. She's a very Philly looking girl, though.
Yeah.
Deanna Brady, I took the picture with her. I liked her. You know, all of them. I gave a shot at all of them. So I was just like, please, one of these girls who I think is really pretty, like me back.
Yeah.
And I was like, I've written notes to everybody. I'm like, I don't know what to do here already. I'm not sure how to, like, do. Cue up the song Amanda by Boston.
Yeah.
So I go home and I'm like, I gotta write her a note. I don't want like these girls to start seeing like same. These notes and I'm writing the same, like, I really like you. I just think we should hang out, blah, blah, blah.
Can I just tell you right now?
Mm-hmm.
This right here is the seed of all plagiarism.
Yeah.
What you are going through right now is the exact moment that Milli Vanilli went through that, well, they didn't plagiarize. They just lip sync. But everyone that's plagiarized and stolen shit goes through this moment that you're feeling right now, which is the search for brand new, different, and good.
Yes. So, my stepfather, not a huge, I guess he likes music a lot, but like, never purchased a lot of music. So what he had was, he had REM Automatic for the People.
Perfect.
He had some Kiss greatest hit stuff. And he had Boston's album, you know, with the spaceship. I think it's Boston's self-titled, right?
Yeah.
And that was just on playing in the background, so we didn't have a lot of tapes in the house, and I'm playing it, and I'm listening to the words, I'm like, this is great. Not overthinking the fact, this song's got way too much love yous, and it's a little heavy.
Yeah.
But I'm not thinking about that. All I'm thinking about is how easy it is
to
take out the word Amanda and put in Deanna.
Oh, it even ends in an A.
Write it. Write the song out. Verse, chorus, verse, chorus, hook, chorus.
Oh.
Clearly looks like a song. I'm not thinking that. I'm thinking she's looking at it as poetic. I'm repeating myself.
Every time you finish a chorus, you're like, God, this is good.
This is good. I give it to her the next day, like it simply, and it's like, you know, and at the end was just like, we should hang out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I want to date you or whatever.
I want to be your boyfriend.
Harsh thing. Yeah, really. Maybe even that blunt. Like, I want to be your boyfriend. Because that's how it was in high school and grade school. It was always that. Which is, let's just go right till fuck.
And then make you understand.
Deanna!
Say it right away. I can't wait another day.
Deanna! Here you go.
I love you.
Oh!
I like you too, Jay.
On beat with that. So I'm just like, this is going to... I give it to... I go, here's my thing. Even as I'm starting to hand it to her, I go, wow, this is a little heavy. But worst case scenario, she laughs it off. She gives it back. What is it? Whatever. She's not into it. Here's what I don't... And I go, worst case scenario, she shows the other girls... Some say it's sweet, some say it's whatever.
Definitely, everyone knows you're a prolific lyric writer.
Definitely, I'm definitely going to have the...
You're at some young Dylan shit.
Here's what I'm completely certain of, though.
Yeah.
Is that my step-pop's coming in. I'm 13, 14, let's even say 15.
Okay.
No, I am the only fucking person in school...
Quoting Boston.
Who knows Boston's fucking first album, yeah. Or that Boston's a band.
Yeah.
Or anything in the world past More Than a Feeling.
Yes.
This is deep tracks.
This is easily one of the deepest B-sides out there. I want to go Mandy if I'm going Barry Manilow.
She shows all the cool girls are her friends.
Okay.
The lottery picks are all her best friends.
Ah, top five.
Walk out.
Yeah.
Just remember that feeling of putting my book bag on, which is a move I always hated because it really shows tit.
Yeah.
It really shows man tit when you're trying to get it on and then straighten all your shirt and shit out.
Well, you got
to
pop the shirt from under the straps or else you're just getting fucking man
boobed. You're just getting boobed. You're just getting cleaved up.
Yeah.
Sure shit. Walking down the hallway, these girls.
I'm going to tell you like a man. I can't wait to know.
Deanna! Like, I was like, I don't even get what you're talking about. This is great.
Was that your shame walk from Game of Thrones?
Just hid
shame.
I hid in school in one way or another, just kind of like, you know, getting the class, kind of dipping off and, you know, and got out of that. And I mean, they laughed at me for fucking weeks about it.
Renee, were you laughed at for that long or that intensely?
Like, for the rest of the year. And then the following year, I'm thinking, oh, they'll forget.
Yeah.
No, but the funny thing is, I actually ran into that. I ran into that same girl that I had a crush on when I went to college for about a year.
And you were at this time. Yeah.
I went up to her and I said, "Hey, my name's Renee. Do you remember me? So we both went to middle school together." She looked at me and she said, "No, I don't know who you are." I'm like, "All right, thank you."
And you're like, "I'm the only guy that can do the splits." In all of our entire middle school.
Don't you? I just got back from the dark arts of the Kumite.
Don't you remember? I have a twin brother. Well, Renee, thank you very much for calling in. And I'm sorry you got your shit pushed in emotionally.
And then I want to take us out on a note. Renee, thank you so much, man. That was a great call, buddy.
Yeah.
Please call again soon. That's Gambit.
We miss you, Gambit.
Just play a little tidbit of this, Lou, before we go in. We could share our lives together. Poor Deanna Brady, I thought it was going to be a fucking murderer.
Yeah. You're going to have it. You had a hair doll, and you're looking for a head as a trophy. Dude, you just told a young girl two
last
things.
Last words.
To say I'm in love with you.
You did three things.
Too heavy.
You told her you loved her.
Several times.
You told her that you might not be around tomorrow. You could be terminal.
Tomorrow might be too late.
Number three. You want to get married with her for the rest of her life. This has been a great episode. This is our last live one until the 30th?
30th. Next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday,
sorry.
So we got two new but not live for you.
Guys, we don't leave you fucking dicking around.
Come on, guys.
We've only done one repeat ever.
And we still got our shit pushed in for it.
Yeah, we really sure did. But I'm telling you what, as every time we can for you guys, we will go new and live.
And we got a good one. We got a Christmas episode, so you can have the whole family listen.
Yes.
Don't be ashamed of it.
I encourage you, get the kids for this one.
Get the little kids.
Everyone on the call list that we didn't get to, I'm very sorry. We love you guys. Please call back next time.
At Big J Oakerson on Twitter, at The Bonfire SXM on Twitter, at Dan Soder on Twitter. Thank you guys for listening. And
now we can say it live. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
We're not Starbucks. I'll just say it.
Yeah, right. I'm going to put the MC back to back. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. And we'll see you. We'll talk to you guys live before the new year. It's The Bonfire. Crackle.
Crackle.
Bye.